Hi, welcome to a new Azure vlog. I hope you're all doing well. I do. I just came back from visiting Prague, where I visited Experts Live Europe. It was an amazing conference. I really had fun over there. I recorded a lot of interviews for Experts Live with a couple of speakers over there. I will put a link in the description to the YouTube channel where you can find those interviews. And actually, in this Azure vlog, I want to talk about Azure Blueprint. But unfortunately, I cannot talk about Azure Blueprint since I haven't talked about Azure Policy yet. So we are first going to talk about Azure Policy. And in the near future, I will do a vlog about Azure Blueprint, which is an amazing service, if you ask me. So let's get into Azure Policy. Azure Policy is a service where you can manage, assign, and create your Azure policies. An Azure policy is a set of rules which you can apply on a resource. And that resource can be an Azure subscription, a resource group, or a resource that you have deployed in your Azure subscription. For example, a virtual machine or a storage account. A good example of an Azure policy is a policy where you have rules in place which, for example, only allow you to deploy resources in the same region as where the resource group is located. As said earlier, you can apply policies on subscription level, resource group level, or on resource level. And it actually works quite simple. If we apply our policy on subscription level, for each resource that will be deployed in that subscription, the policy will be evaluated. If I have deployed the policy on a resource group, the policy will only be evaluated for resources that are deployed within that resource group. So we can have a layered construction over there. So let's not talk too much. Let's directly go into a demo. But first, I have to do this. There is no Azure vlog without coffee. So let's grab a cup of coffee and I'll show you a demo. So let's get started. Let me show you the policy console in the Azure portal. To go to the policy console, there are multiple ways, but the fastest way I found out is to type in policy in the search bar of the portal. And here we are in the policy portal. You can see we can see all our assignments. At this moment, I've assigned one policy to a resource group. We can see all the definitions of policies that are in there. There are lots of them today. We can even create our own policies. We can see the compliance is the resource group on which we applied the policy compliant. So without any further ado, let's assign a policy to a resource group and let me show you how it works. Imagine you're an organization and you want to let your developers deploy their own virtual machines, but you only want them to deploy the cheap virtual machines. You might want to give them access to the resource group and add a policy that only allows them to deploy certain virtual machine sizes, so you're not end up at the end of the month with a large bill. So let me show you in this demo how we can set up such a policy. In order to go to the policy management console, go to the search bar and type in policy. Click on policy and this is your policy portal. This is where you can assign, define, and manage your policies. if we want to assign a policy that only allows us to deploy certain types of virtual machines, go to assignments, click on assign policy, on the scope select your resource group. In my case, I choose the AV demo 2 resource group, and for the policy I think it was somewhere down. Allowed virtual machine SKU. And this policy has some parameters. We can select the virtual machines that we want to be able to let our developers deploy. And it are those B series that are the cheapest ones. So we alone only allow them to deploy B series virtual machines. We have 6 of them selected. Now we assign the policy, and this policy has been assigned to our resource group. Now let's go over to that resource group, demo 2. You'll see there is nothing deployed in there yet. Let's click add. Let's click a Windows server, create. Resource group AV demo 2, AV demo, it's the name of my virtual machine. For the size, we see that there is now a DS1 V2 selected. That is a virtual machine that was not in the list of allowed SKUs that we allow people to deploy in this resource group. I give it a username, a password. And the rest, we leave it default. Now it's running the validation, and the validation has been filled. Let's check the details. We see that the validation has been filled. That's because of our policy. We didn't allow this SKU, this virtual machine size, to be deployed in this resource group. So let's now go back to the basics. Change the virtual machine size and make it a B1S. Now we are starting the validation again, and we see that it passed the validation. So we can now deploy the virtual machine. And now let's talk about governance. Imagine you already have an environment and you already have a Azure design, and you want to know if your environment is compliant with your design. We can use Azure policy for that. Azure policy not only enforces certain rules on your resources, but you can also use it to report on compliancy. To do so, let's go to the policy console and let's go to compliance. When we go to the compliancy, we can see how compliant this environment is with the policies that we've set up. As you see, there are currently two policies set up. One, the allowed virtual machines queues, that's the one we set up in the previous demo. And one is the audit resource location matches group location. This one is auditing if a certain resource is in the same location as where its resource group is deployed. In this case, it's not compliant, and that's actually true. Before I started this demo session, I deployed a resource group, which is deployed in West Europe. And in that resource group, I deployed a storage account, which is deployed to North Europe. So we can also use Azure policy to monitor on compliancy. Quite a handy tool, quite interesting. So with that, let's end this demo session. So in this vlog, we saw how Azure policy can help us to enforce certain rules and effects on resources. And we also saw that Azure policy can help us to report on the compliancy of our environment. What I did not mention is that every policy gets evaluated from time to time by the policy engine. Those evaluations will be used to create the compliancy report. So every policy that you define will also report on the current state of the scope where it's in deployed. for example, a resource group or maybe on subscription level. I hope you found this vlog interesting. If so, please hit the thumbs up button. Also, subscribe to this channel. And of course, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.